Well, now that now you're talking something a little different. I don't know if you've heard her, but she's asking about, she's going to take a gap year, and if I could put words in your mouth, this might not be exactly what you're saying, but it's applicable to the group, of can you apply and get in and then take a gap year? Choose to hold your application for a year, and the answer is yes, you can do exactly. But you have to have a good reason. You have to say, you know, you can't go lay on the beach for a year, because we will rescind the application. But you can go that way. You can choose to say, I'm going to go ahead and apply because I've got my application in order. I want to go ahead and get in med school, get that done, and then I'm going to go to Europe and study, you know, blah, blah, blah for the year. And I would like to delay my matriculation for a year. And if that's a reasonable request, you can do it that way. And then those other things follow for you. So there are two ways to do that. Does that make sense? You can either decide to take a year and apply in the regular way to next year's school, or you can go and then take a gap year. But you have to get approval. Another question? Yeah, and if anybody needs to go, it doesn't hurt my feelings. I'm here for y'all. So please understand, I know your life is busy and a lot going on. Any other questions?
Can you figure out
best
where that house is? So I'm kind of wanting to go here as well. And I'm kind of in this situation where I'm not sure if I want to continue my education with the major that I'm in, kind of psych major, or if I want to go to med school. So like, can I say something like, I wanted that gap here to figure out like which option is going to be best for me at getting experience and possibly I guess not completely devoting myself to getting all these things that I would need for med school or all these things that I would need for education for my master's. So I'm kind of in school, like, which is where I want to take my future. And I'm interested in both. I have some protection between both.
Well, what I'm hearing you say is you're just not sure what you want to do. So I would almost force you to. I would say, gosh, no, don't go for something when you're not 100% sure that's what you want. And so it makes perfect sense for me for you to take that gap year to make that decision accordingly. Now, the gap year has to be substantive such that it helps you make the decision. And you can validate that gap year had you done so. I'd say you definitely, I mean, just the way you're saying it to me right now, I'm telling you, take a gap. Yeah, you may need 2 years. And that's fine, because when you want to go to med school, you want to know, no holds barred here. There's nothing else I want to do. I'm going to be a doctor. This is what I'm going to do. It's the right time, and I'm going to do it. And if it is, then I'm saying, no, don't do it. You know, go ahead and get what you need to do. And some it's just age. You're older. You see life differently. You have an experience that pushes you toward it or pushes you away from it. And then you're ready. There's nothing wrong with that.
Okay, so I get into that interview,
and
that will be okay for me to say, you know, I wanted to put my efforts towards both because I wasn't sure quite which one I wanted to be, and I was trying to figure out which one.
And now I figured it out.
Sorry?
And now I have figured it out. And the follow-up question is going to be, and how do I know that? And then you would, you know, have to defend your position. So, yeah, you generally, with a gap year, you're going to have to defend why you take the gap year, but it's very defensible, as long as it is defensible. Do you see? Because it's what's known as a non-traditional student, and we love non-traditional students are fine, but they have to be, they have to make sense as to why they're not. And some people, you know, just didn't know they wanted to be a doctor. They went to college, they played around, they got a degree, they went out there and returned to this, and then came back and retook courses and because they saw they wanted to be a doctor. I just interviewed one Wednesday, 30 years old. He was a professional baseball player in his life. And then he got hurt. And then he got into the, because he was hurt, he had a lot of experiences in the medical system. Work they were doing, and blah, 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 I can't go any further, but there he is, and applying to medical school. So there are lots of different avenues to getting in, but common to it is you want to be a doctor, and you know what being a doctor is about within reason, and you're ready to be a doctor, and give what, you know, I call medical school, and many of you have heard me probably, if you heard before, say this. Now, process what I'm getting ready to say, okay? It's a very jealous mistress. Now, if you're not smiling, you didn't catch it. Okay, so think about it. It's a very jealous mistress. And it is. It requires a lot of you. Yeah, and yet you have other responsibilities, but it's not going to give. It's going to say they have to come second. But you get the point. So that's because medical school's tough. And I've just told you, you got to do well because the residency is down the line potentially. So, you know, it's just, it's got to come together so that, we want you to be successful. And we want you to be happy, and we want to do everything we can. And I think at our school, you know, the personal education you get at our school is paramount. You're not going to get lost in the numbers. I know every student, probably they don't want me to know them, but I do. And I work hard with them. It's interactive, and I'm passive. We get by. They can't just sit in the back row. It doesn't work. Because I'm there pushing as hard as I can, but I'm pushing for them. Yeah, no, they're not. I'm sure they're not. Certainly not. And that's what you advertise your weaknesses, so we don't either. What I would do is ask the students. They'll tell you. That's the easy way to go. And I can sit here and I get the same question about the pediatric residency. What are your strengths of your residency? What are your weaknesses? Let me give you a perfect example of the residency. For here in Columbia, in pediatrics, the state of South Carolina is so big, and you have to have a critical mass. And so we have given to complex congenital heart surgery. We're not doing that here. We have four pediatric cardiologists. We taught everything about cardiac surgery. If you wanted to work in the operating room with congenital heart disease, then you don't want to go to our residency. That's a weakness. But is that a weakness? Is that what you want to do? And if it's not, then it's not a weakness. So you see the point. So a lot of the weaknesses are defined more about your interest, and you have to be a little careful. I was talking to someone earlier about board pass rates. And, you know, you have to be careful about math. Math doesn't lie, but you have to understand that certain schools may say our pass rate is 100%, but they didn't let anybody take the test, which we've always let everybody take the test. You know, so you have to look at things in depth. And I'm not saying you're doing anything nefarious or wrong. I'm just saying that number looks pretty good if you just stopped there relative to another school if everybody was allowed to take it. So when you look at strengths and weaknesses, you know, it's a little bit of a moving target. And bottom line, in medical school, for all the schools in the state, you will get a good education. I mean, it's just, I would be lying if I told you, oh, my God, don't go there. That's just not fair. In the same breath, certainly I see our school regarding the personal education you get, you know, having some strengths that, if they are aligned with what you want and work for you, then need to be considered. Does that make sense? Another question?
Any more questions, guys?
Where is the Chick-fil-A? That's my question. Oh, you're welcome.